Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this Minecraft texture pack video, we'll be changing this basic look here, standard Minecraft look, over to a look more like Mars, kind of a sci-fi look. And we'll start off by changing these five different textures here. That's coarse dirt and grass dirt, regular dirt, sand, and stone. Okay, let's get to it. Put that on hold for a minute. There we go. And I'll bring up the Photoshop Elements program to adjust these textures. Now you can use any graphics program you want. I just happen to like Photoshop Elements. It's inexpensive and does a great job for this kind of work. Okay, let's go ahead and bring that up. Okay, there's elements in the background, and in the foreground I have a folder here where I have my basic resource pack information. Now you'll need three parts. You need the pack.png image, the pack.mc meta file right here. You can download both of these, and there's a link for that in the description, and it's in a zip file called resourcepackfiles.zip. And then you also need the assets in here. Now if you don't have the assets folder ready to go, take a look at my previous video on creating custom texture packs, and there is a link for that in the description and also up there upper right hand corner in the cards. Okay, once we have this, we need to then go into assets and then Minecraft and textures right down here. I need to look in two places, block and color map. We'll look in color map first, and you want one that says grass.png. Now I've already converted this one. It will look like this over here normally. So you want to have the grass.png file open right there, and then back into textures again, go into block, and in this big list here of different blocks, you need to pull out five of those, and they're right up here. There's stone and sand, grass block side, dirt, and coarse dirt. Now I'm picking these because these are mostly what you'll see when you're looking at a landscape. Other things will be there as well, but this is most of it. And once you understand the process here, you can go through and pick up the other few that you may see elsewhere and take a look at that as we get through this. So that's what you need, the color map over here and then these five texture blocks. And before we get into those, let's quickly change our image here. This is just the image that's used inside of Minecraft to show this particular custom texture pack. So grab this PNG file right here, and also I have a picture of Mars over here. I'll grab both of those, just drag those into elements. There we are. And then I'll take this picture of Mars and I'll drag it right on top of that kitty cat, and let's get rid of that. And then hold down the Control T keyboard shortcut. That gives you your control handles in here, and I can now resize this to fit. And I'll just put it kind of like that. Looks good. Choose OK and we'll save this. I'll save it twice. First as a default PSD file, that's your Photoshop Elements file. That way it saves my layers over here, and I recommend doing that in any program you use, and go ahead and save the layers out. So I'll do a file and save. There it is. That way I can always go back and easily change the picture in the future. Save me a couple of steps next time around. And then go up to File and come down to Save for Web. All I want to do here is simply to convert this to a PNG file, and I'm using PNG 8 on this one. It's 128 by 128 pixels. The image is already at that size. As long as it's PNG 8, that's fine. Choose Save, and make sure we save this into our proper location, which is that folder right there. It'll save on top of that one, and replace. Okay, that's taken care of, and that's now out of the way. There we go. All right, let's now come in and work with these things. Now, I'm doing this real easy, and I'll just use this middle one here as an example. What I've done to make this just a cinch, since all we need to do is to give these an orange tint, the easiest way is just to bring in a color layer in here. Let me show you that layer. There it is, a color layer on top of the image layer, and then just use a blending mode here to blend the color into that image. Most graphics programs can do this basic concept, simply taking a color and blending it in. If you can't do that, depending upon your graphics program, just use your hue saturation controls, and there will be one of those in your program, and shift the hue over to the oranges. But I found this is even easier, and it makes it a cinch to simply copy this over into your other files. I'm going to show you that real fast. I'll just get rid of this layer here. There we go. So let's say I had it all set up here. All I need to do then, again, this is inside of Photoshop Elements. If Photoshop works the same way, most programs work the same way. Take your layer and just drag it over to your other image, and there it goes. It copies that over onto that image. Now I've done that already for all of these. Just bring those back in. There we go, even on the color map over here, same exact trick. Now, because of the colors, you may need to make some slight adjustment on this. Now on this one, and also this one, these are all darker than the orange color. So on these, I was able to use the soft light blend mode, and that looked the best. I mean, there are different blend modes in here I could choose, like that. But the soft light looked the best. It gave me the nicest, just kind of an orange overall coloration in there. So those are all with the soft light. Going on to sand, it didn't look so good. There's the original sand. It didn't look so good with the soft light, but I found that color burn, which is up here, gave me a nice coloration. So I did color burn for the sand. And then over on the grass, same problem. The soft light didn't look too good, and that's right there. It didn't really do much at all, as you can see. But I found that just doing a color shift did what I wanted. It made everything that color. Okay, that's all taken care of then. Real straightforward. All basically the same thing. A little difference on the blend mode just to get a nice color. Once that's done, simply save all these. I've already saved these as the default PSD file. That's your Photoshop file or Photoshop Elements file. And then once that's done, save it out as a PNG8. Inside of Photoshop Elements, you use the Save for Web. Over in Photoshop, you just do a Save As. Most programs do a Save As or an Export For. But you want to use the PNG8 and choose Save. Make sure you go back into the right location. This, of course, is the grass we're looking at, and that's going to be in the Textures and Color Map. And there it is. I've already saved it right there. Okay, now we have all of that done. So these are all saved. We can now get this out of the way. There's our new pack.png image. There's the pack.mcmeta. There's our assets with our changed images in here. We can now zip all three of these files together. So this one, that one, and that one. Need those three files zipped together. Come down to Add to Archive. And let's give this one a name up here. We'll just call this one Mars Textures. Mars Textures 1. That's good. Choose OK and let that zip all this stuff together into one zip file. Once I have that zip file, we can then simply copy this over into the resource pack location for Minecraft, and it will then be accessible for us right from that resource pack location. Very, very easy to do. The hard part really is just figuring out how you want to adjust the colors. Now in the coloration that I used, I just did a simple orange because it's kind of a Mars thing. But you can give a different color to each part of the textures if you want to. It's really up to you. We're just doing kind of a theme here, kind of an orangish based theme. Okay, so there is our resource pack right there. Go back into Minecraft and click on Options and Resource Packs. And then down here where it says Open Resource Pack Folder, choose that one. And there's a resource pack folder. Here's a couple of ones I've been working on to get this coloration right. So here's our textures. I'll just right drag that over here and copy it into the resource pack location. We can then close that down. We're done with that. We're done with that. And we're done here. Click Done again. And you're back to this menu page, back to Options, back to Resource Packs, and there's that new texture pack right there. Click on the arrow. Brings it in over here as the top option, and that of course is the default and the running one, one that's actually being run. Click on Done. This will then relaunch Minecraft with that new texture. Click Done, back to game, and there we go. There's our nice kind of orangey brown look. Let's just go back to full screen again. There we go. Now, let's see how this looks. The grass looks real nice. There's the kind of a brown color for the grass. The dirt has all changed. Sand has changed, and the stone has changed. Now, in the background back there, we have this stuff here. That's probably sandstone as opposed to sand, so I have to go back and find that texture and change that one as well. If we walk around, you can see a few more things have changed. Of course, the sand here and the hill looks just fine, kind of a nice orangey color in there. There's that coarse dirt right there. That looks fine. Notice that also some of the small bushes have changed as well right there. Let's go around the corner here. Notice that the tree has not changed. There's no change on the tree, so I'll have to take care of the tree. We'll be doing trees in the next video and get these things a nice sci-fi color as well. But again, the bushes look good. And around over here, the bamboo actually hasn't changed at all, but the sugarcane has changed. So it's changed most everything. If you look back in there, there are still some other textures that will need to be adjusted, but most everything has been handled by those five textures we took care of, and also by the grass coloration. See that these bushes have actually pulled their color information from the grass color. So there we go. There's our first pass here, the first bit of work on changing this over to a Mars coloration, and then we'll do those trees next week in the next video. And if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button, and of course, share. Just click on share and share with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe as well if you haven't already done so, and help my channel by supporting it through Patreon, and there's a link for the Patreon right down there in the description.